Hello, people. We are back on our map. I'm gonna try a couple of things today. First off, I wanna make ice caps. So to do that, let's find our lines. So let's say these are the maximum where our ice caps will be. Select inverse, filter render clouds. Oh, let's do it in black and white. There we go. And we put a threshold on it. Make it with a clipping mask. Let's see. Gonna make this easier. I'll just blur this layer and do the clouds again. And then I'll start burning and dodging. So burning takes away areas, and dodging or holding the alt key brings areas back in. I'm just trying to get the rough shape of the ice cap. Let's put it on screen so only the white shows through, so we can interact with the land a bit more, like this. And I guess they should line up at the edges. If you want to be really precise, you can. What's the button? I want to show rulers. You can go like this. Add to guide layers. Right, I like that. Turn those off. Think if we merge these two together, we will only get the transparent bits. No. How did I do that? All right, let's see. We want to get all this black stuff and get it out like this, and then we put this underneath and merge, and now we only have the transparent bits left, which is nice, and we can clean up the ice caps a bit with the hard brush. containing white. My computer's acting up. Let's give it a sec. There we go. Whoa. Chill out. See that? Computer was being really weird. Okay. One thing that I can do, I think, is just go like this. Make a new layer. Select, modify, smooth selection by 2 pixels. Let's see what that does. Yeah, that will do. And we'll fill in these gaps with white. Oh. Let's do it like this. Because there was some transparency in the bottom one. I want to merge them together a couple of times so we make sure that we've got the hard edges and not the soft edges. So then we can also see that there's still some value here, which we can remove. All right, let's fill them in. These are all presets that I made before, which makes my life a little bit easier. I make a preset for a hard brush, soft eraser, hard eraser. Part. I saw that. I know you saw it. You're thinking, did he saw that? Did he see that? Yeah, I saw that. I will fix it up. Nice, we've got some ice caps. Let's call them ice caps. Make a nice map for them because it's getting more and more messy with layers and things like that. Look, so many layers already. All right. For the ice caps, we want some texture. Create clipping mask, so only the top layer will only show up on whatever this layer has content. I will render clouds. I will render different clouds. Invert, stylize, emboss. Then I'm also gonna give the ice caps a little bit, so this can be an overlay. Oh, that doesn't work because this is totally white. So we'll lower the lightness of this ice caps, and I also wanna give it a little bit of a color. A little bit of blue in there. let's try like this. And I want, basically I want the outer layers to show less than the inner layers. Less texture. So what we will do is we will expand by 25 pixels. Sorry, contract by 25 pixels. And let's contract some more. Feather by 25 pixels. Select inverse. And we'll just paint on that. Let's see. You see now these edges have less texture than the inner land. I'm not sure if this is realistic actually. Like, maybe the edge should have more texture than the inner land. Because the edge is more steep and the inner land is more flat. However, we have to fix these edges with a soft brush. We will paint them with black to remove this border, because we were at the edge of the map. Same for the bottom one. What we can do is we can just copy this layer, invert the selection, create clipping mask. So this is inside inner ice cap. This is outer ice cap. And just soften it a little bit, so we still have got some texture going on at the inside, but just a lot less than on the edges. Keep it like that for now. If you take a look at the ice caps on Google Maps, we can see. Oh, the Google Maps doesn't show ice caps. It only shows Antarctica. This Greenland, there's no ice caps. So let's check out Antarctica, what they did there. Nothing much. Can do is what happens if there's, ooh, we don't want it. I want to get rid of a lot of layers because the layers are becoming more and more clustered and messy. So I just want to see if I can give this thing a color from itself. Oh, this is the whole ocean color. Okay. Never mind. I'm gonna give this continental shelf as well, even though it's kind of weird because the ice flows on top of the water and doesn't necessarily have a shelf underneath, I think. So let's see. Let's just try. We'll call it ice shelf. And we can also push it in a bit with our smudge tool. And we have to push in the mask. And what we think, what I think we can do is we can move the whole shelf up a little. How can we do that? Can we do it like this? I don't think so. We can do it like this for a small part. Let's change it. So these are just textures. We can merge it for now, making life a little bit easier. There we go. Let's see. No pattern. Okay, we'll leave this for now. This one can go up a little bit more, I think. Let's check our this continental shelf backup can go. This all part of the ocean. Feel like we can merge those. What's happening? Why am I not allowed to merge these? I'm allowed to merge. Huh? That's so strange. I'm allowed to merge them one by one. Okay. So I do like this. Still be able to make more ridges, so I'll leave that open. And what we can also do is we can, for the ease of finding our layers, we can change their colors. It's a lot easier to finding different things. So if we close off this, what's interesting, we can find our original how we found the shapes, things like that. I will save it as backup, so we can easily get all the way back. And then we can just delete these layers. So let's save this as our main file. This one can go. Values are nice, but I don't think we need them anymore. We do need our wind and water map. It's always good to check what they look like in grayscale, so we can see if it translates well. So what I see here is this is not translating well at all. This can go dark a little, and then the continental shelves have to go up. Let's change this for a second. So I want want this one to be 100%, but then I will change the Vel and Emboss settings. So this can go a little bit more like this, and this can be a little bit more like this. Ice caps need much more value, but we'll fix that later. And the, let's see how this looks. Whoa, that's the problem. You can't see the colors, but that's okay. So to change this continental shelf color, we'll change this color overlay. Sorry, not the overlay. We'll change this. Let's just put it on top for a second. And instead of screen, we'll go to normal. We'll take our blue color, bump it up a little. And maybe go to a different view of blue. This outer glow changes the color of the edges. So I want this size to be I'm not an expert on how this exactly works, so that's is it a problem? I don't know, maybe. This is better. So we'll give that some color. We can also do it with hard light, I think. No, it will become more. It will become more saturated if I do hard light. So we won't do that. Let's keep it like this for now. Now if we check our values, this is already reading a little bit better. I want the value of our ice cap to change. This is our ice shelf. This. Check our values. The ice caps are too bright. try to keep it like this for now. All right, next up, I want to make colors in the land. And to do proper colors, in my experiment, I tried to do it with hard light. I didn't like it because I couldn't color pick properly. So what I want is I want preferably to be my have my land layer on normal. So I can just color pick the right colors. However, then we want the lights to be on screen so the color pops through. Let's see, cancel. Let's find the correct blending mode. I think it doesn't change a thing because I have to change this color mode. Yeah, it's because we have double mountains. So let's remove this mountain for now. And see if this helps. This is confusing. So I want the white not to be white, but a lighter shade of green. I thought I had to do it with screen. Soft light works. Overlay does too. Lighten doesn't, screen doesn't. So let's keep it with soft light. Turn the multiply down a little and add a copy of it. What if we blur this one a little. Like that. And then we do the same for the hills. We put it on soft light. Alright. Let's take a look at the map as a whole. Good. Then I've got to find some colors that I really like. And there's a map that I really, really like, but I won't show it because of copyright reasons. However, I will copy some colors from it. So let's see if I can do this on my second screen. Just zoom in a lot. So I will only take a tiny, tiny, tiny image. This works. I guess it did. This is my background. This is the map that I was talking about. So I like this green. And with this green, we can just start painting on top. No, I'm not gonna do that. Before I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna make a little bit of color palette. So we could take this green color. We can take this yellowish color. We can take this grayish color. Let me take another bit of this map. Darker green, take this brown, next we go for a bit more desert colors. Alright, This will be our color palette for now. By the way, the Cartographers Guild is amazing. It's a website and a forum. Also, the Facebook group is really good, where you can just learn so much about map making. Color palette. Let's take the hill brush we made earlier and start drawing in where our deserts should be. So let's see. Here we've got some deserts, here we've got some deserts. This is a previous thing. And for now, let's just sketch these in so we have an easier time finding them. Without having this whole mess on top. Let's just start mapping them in with opacity layers or lower opacity. And then I'll just color pick this green, draw back over this edge. It's nice to have some lighter bits and some darker bits. Being a little bit slow. We'll just grab our greens, go back on top. If we're afraid about that leaf, sometimes if you blend, you just lose the color a little bit, it becomes more desaturated. So we can just go on top like this, just color pick again. Keep blending back and forth between the greens and the deserts. cool. It's a little bit annoying that I can't see directly what I'm doing because of my computer just can't process making videos and making a detailed map like this at the same time, so it slows down my brush strokes. We can also pick maybe a color like this, go a little bit along the edges. Can still adjust. That looks pretty cool. The only thing that I see is that this desert is much more blended than the other one. So what we can do is just take a big brush, put it on 1% and go over it like once or twice to even those out. Cool. We'll go back in and add some more deserts. Computer is slowing down. Close my cloud system. Alright, and let's not forget to save. Very important. Save, save, save. a look. That's pretty cool. So next up, I want to paint the polar regions, or the cold northern European, southern Argentinian, cold temperate regions. So let's take a look, just like this, and we will use the 60 degrees north as a guide. By the way, if you want this overlay for yourself, you can check it on onlinetabletop.com, where I already have made one mapping tutorial. Turn this off. And there I explain what exactly I'm doing. So let's save this, and I will open that tutorial for you. So this is my website, and if you go down and you scroll through an article I wrote in January 2017, you find this how to make a custom map for your fantasy world. And it is it's not a video, it's just text, and here you can see how I explain it step by step, and I just copied this to use it for my map. So it's the poles with the degrees, the different zones, the wind directions, and it's based on how it works on Earth. I'm not a geologist or a climatologist or whatever it's called, but it is nice. I based it on the knowledge that I had, and just having some guides to work off gives your map some more realism. And in this map, I made more hand-drawn feel, and that's why for this tutorial I'm going more for a satellite-like feel, like a satellite image. So let's check Google Maps for a second, because I think the forests around the temperate zones are more dark. It's more dark looking. And I mean, like, for example here, Scandinavia is a bit darker than the grasses and the trees down here. It's interesting how you've got these big blocks of darker color in there. What is this? Is this just forest? Let's Minkibe National Park. It's just jungle, I think. Yeah. Oh, this is so long a national park, but I guess this is just jungle, so the jungles can be a lot darker. Then the temperate forests near the south. And the north, like Alaska, can be dark as well. And those are just dark, dark forests. All right, good to know. So let's take this. Go for a little bit more dark. Does this look? I want it a little less saturated. Yeah, we'll go for this. Just dropping in some cold colors wherever the water might be pushing in cold air and cold water, and then taking the dark greens around those areas. Crawling a little bit more around the edges like this. I lost some of the color. Come to the north side of the island like this. see how that looks. It looks pretty cool. We'll detail it more later. The bottom part. So we take this color, make it a little bit darker. We can maybe add it to our color swatch as well. Let's first see if it's the right color. Let's saturate it. Still to saturate it. Let's go back. This one. Looks better. Color palette. There we go. Since we now have a color for our cold regions, we can also apply this to our ice caps. Sorry, color overlay, we want this one. Let's do this, not this way. Let's see, how can we do this? So this layer has the textures. Still make this a clipping mask and overlay. Remove all color. So this is a colors. And now if we paint in with a little bit of a brighter color, this should work. Thank you. this weird. We don't want it. We want this to be our mask. There we go. Feel we are losing a lot of texture right now on those ice caps. So what we can do is we can maybe duplicate the texture layer. These relay. I like it. Let's see how well it translates in black and white. Much too bright, the ice caps. We'll keep it like this for now. Okay, what's next? Maybe give our mountains some color. If the computer wants to help me. Come on. Wow, it's having a difficult time. We are still up and running. Hey, Photoshop starting to move. Nice. Okay, mountains. Making the peaks of the mountains a little bit white. And then we'll come in with the green. We can also maybe make the green a bit less saturated to make it more of a earth tone. Some more of the earth tone on the higher hills. And then on the wet side of the mountain, and we can check that by where our wind is coming from. Let's see, wind, so we can be closed. Wind. So there we can see which side is our more wet side of the mountains, because usually, like, no, let's check this. No, check this. So the mountains collect water, right? And warm and dry air is getting blown this direction. So that means that this will be more of a dry area. So we can just let's do this. So let's check, this is the dry side of the mountain. This is the dry side of the mountain. This is warm and dry air getting pushed on this side of the mountain and on this side of the mountain as well. Oh, sorry, those are not my mountains. Warm and dry air is on this side. This is cold and wet air, warm and dry air. So this is the dry side. Is the equator. So warm and dry air on this side of the mountain. And let's take our blue color and check which side is wet. This is cold and wet, so this will be more of a wet side. This will be the wet side of the mountain. This will be the wet side of the mountain. This is an interesting mountain because it's here's a little bit more wet. More wet. Alright. So now we turn off this guy. And we can start throwing in more vegetation on the wet side and more dry on the dry side. Allemaal in Photoshop. So we'll have some beautiful forests on this side. Excuse me. Just blending. cooler. One thing that I don't like is that our mountains seem to be a bit too obvious. Or what do you call it? So what do we do? We can go over with a bit of an earth zone, maybe. Right, a lot of progress. I like it. We're starting to get somewhere. Turn off the color profile. Now that we've got some things going on, maybe we can start drawing in some rivers. Know where the wet sites are. Let's start drawing in some rivers. So the more squiggly and details these rivers are, the better. So they collect water in the mountains, and then they come together and make a bigger river. And these are the big rivers on our map. The tiny ones you almost don't even see on this scale, or the smaller ones. So these are the rivers like the Amazon or the Mississippi, the big rivers. Cheat. No cheating. There's a first river. Make a small one around here. has got the river police. Because you're not allowed to split the river in the direction of the ocean. Because they do not naturally do that. Whenever you start making fancy maps and you go on the Cartographer's Guild and you show your map, the river police will be very angry. There's a lot of foreign people that are specialized in which direction the river should go, and they will get angry about the direction of your rivers and the splitting and things like that. Like, even this shouldn't happen. I don't mind too much, but it's good to be as realistic as you possibly can be. Just to give your story and your world more depth. So we're getting a lot of cool rivers. Let's make another big one. Let's make this our biggest, craziest river. like it. This area needs some more rivers as well. We could just follow the shape of the bumps texture we already made before, even though we will make some changes. Alright, so let's take our land layer, select inverse. Oh no, we can just make a mask. Let's do that. So the rivers will stay in the land. And then we can give it a color. Something's going on again in the Photoshop. We'll give it a second. And we're back. Nice. This might be interesting, so to simulate that our rivers are lower than the rest of our land, and that's the reason why it did collect its water. We can maybe add a bevel. Just a tiny, tiny touch. I like it. Change the color a little bit. We'll fix that later. All right. So now, whenever we get close, we can see that there are some rivers. Fix the color. And we can always add some more later. So, last thing, let's see if there's any. So, you've got those Great Lakes, right? Great Lakes. That's in the Netherlands. That's not what I meant. So there are some lakes that you could see from the space. So this is Great Lakes. There are couple of big ones. Let's copy this. Change content. Call this lakes. And just add a couple of interesting lakes here and there. Let's do it differently. We delete this layer mask. Let's delete this whole thing. Let's go with black. Delete layer mask. Mask here. Black. No, I'm gonna do it different. Rivers. Delete content, and I'm gonna throw it in like this first and add a texture later. These are just rough shapes, so maybe add a bit of a lake here. Want to try avoid drawing little testicles. Sometimes I just dot in like, then it turns out to look like, maybe it's just my dirty mind, I don't know. Let's do an inner glow. From the center. And make it a little bit more greenish. Greenish blue. Outer glow from with darker green. Try it like that. Okay. So let's make sorry, let's make a new pattern that you can use in the pattern overlay. I will show you how you can make a seamless pattern. So to make something seamless, you want to make sure that they can fit on every side, right? So there's a thing called offset, and then I made 1,000 by 1,000, so if I make this 500 by 500, the edge should be in the center. Then I get the clone tool and I'll just start cloning in some bits. Being very gentle near the edges. Then it should be almost seamless. So now if I offset it by 250, because my original was 1,000, so first I do it halfway, and now it's like a quarter. I think it's somewhere here or here. But here it is, I think. But it's already harder to recognize the edge of the seam. I think we got it. So then we go to edit and define pattern, and we call this lakes. Now when we go to legs, pattern overlay, and then we scroll down to find our legs pattern. Just scale it down a lot. Put an overlay. Our legs are black. We don't want that. We want to give it a color. So let's fill it with this color. Then we should have some texture in our lake. It's not a lot. Photoshop is loading. Maybe we should experiment with putting the bevel and emboss up or down. So if we look at our lakes like this, there's a dark edge around the lake. But I don't really like this Google Maps lakes style. Look, we're gonna find the lake near my house. Here it is. This is the lake where I always swim. I either swim here, or I swim here, in this water over here. Or I swim here. No, down is correct. Inner glow. I don't know, we'll keep it like this for now. All right, let's take a look at our map so far. I'll also try to sort out my Photoshop issues because this is really weird. It's going far too slow. Maybe it's because I don't have much hard drive space left. I don't like the lakes just yet, but we'll get to that later. I will figure out what our next steps will be. We made a lot of progress today, and yeah, we will go into the details even more the next time. Talk to you later.